is manipulated.
Yes, sir.
Can I tell y'all this tonight? The devil ain't studying about your money. He don't care nothing about your car. He don't care nothing about your house. He don't care about how much land you got. He don't care about how much money you have. What he wants is your mind.
Yes, sir.
That's his playground. He will have you thinking things that really ain't what they are. Why do you think that we have people killing folk with no remorse? Well, don't they hear me here? Why you think we have people doing it and people are being influenced and we don't want to talk about it, but they're being influenced by things on television. Things that they hear, music that they hear, they're being influenced by these different spirits. How can a young man go to a theater dressed up like the Joker and start killing people because he thought he was part of the movie? It's because it's a spirit. And the only way you're going to get control over that is not bickering and not fighting one another, but somebody got to use the power that God has given you. My weapons of warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through pulling down of strongholds. Nobody want to deal with it. Nobody want to talk about it. What is it? What is it that's controlling young people to kill innocent people? What's controlling people even in the area, even in the community, even in the country? What is it is motivating them to take innocent people's lives? It's a spirit that has been loosed in the atmosphere. But I said it all last night, in your people. And think everything gonna work. You can't keep God out there crazy and think everything's gonna work. Y'all don't hear me here. God spoke to me and I wrote a song called Let's Get Along. And I was talking about the races and talking about the church and talking about everybody, because it's time for us to realize that we ain't the only ones saved. He got people everywhere. And if this bothering you, I'm sorry. But it's time for us to come out the box.
Amen.
And start challenging spirits. We're in warfare. This ain't no play thing. I may not tune in tonight, but I got to get this. This ain't no play thing. This ain't nothing to play with. This thing is escalating. It's because the church is satisfied with being in the church. When Jesus was anointed and he went in the places that people wouldn't go in. And then when he went in those places, he made a difference.
Yes, sir.
When he died, he said, greater works than these shall we do.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
So we sat in church, and the enemy has us divided. And we think that we got a monopoly on God. Because we Pentecostal. Because we Baptist. Well, the last time I checked, when you get to heaven, ain't gonna be no sex. Thank you.
Have thy will, Lord.
Hallelujah. We got to get it right.
Get it right.
I'm going to sound like one for us. We got to get it right.
Because
if we can't get together down here, we can't get together. We got to start challenging these things. Everything on TV now. Everything on the radio now. We're exposed to a whole lot of things.
Yes, sir.
Gang activity is up. People are not safe around their own houses no more. People work hard for their stuff and then people break in and take what they worked hard for. And you mean to tell me that we're just going to sit and not challenge? What's going on in the earth? And then everybody has a name for it. But when you come to the common denominator, the real thing is it's a spirit.
Yes, sir.
And our weapons of warfare are not like the world's weapons.
Well,
if I got to kill your character to build me up, then I ain't supposed to be there in the first place. If I got to assassinate you or pull you down for me to get to a certain place, then it ain't for me. I don't want it. Because, beloved, let me say this to you tonight. There's so many things that are going on in my life. I'm not talking about your life, but my life. To where I want to see the hand of God.
Yes.
I got unsaved relatives. I got people. I got people that I want to see come to Christ. I got people that I want to see healed. Oh, y'all don't hear me here.
Yes, sir.
Do you believe Isaiah 53 and 5?
Yes, sir.
He was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquity. The chastisement of my peace was upon him. And with his stripes, I ain't just quoting you no scripture. You looking at somebody as evidence that he's a healer.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Diagnosed with asthma. Look like my next breath would be my last breath. And my mama couldn't afford to go to the emergency room because at that time daddy had just died. And these two little boys are sitting. One had sickle cell and the other was breathing. Looked like his last breath. But I heard my mom say, in the name of Jesus. Something popped in my chest. I'm talking about real stuff. I ain't talking about man. I'm talking about real stuff. Something popped in my chest. And I've been breathing and hollering like I'm hollering right now. If I can't come to the church for healing, where can I go? If I can't come to his presence in the house of God, where can I go? Where can I go? What can I do? What is it?
Jesus.
David recognized his sin after he was told. After he was told and he recognized his sin, he came before a gracious Father. And he said, create in me a clean heart. And renew a right spirit within me.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In other words, God correct whatever is wrong.
That's right.
As much as I love you, I can't do it for you. God has to do it.
All right.
But we got to learn that we can't get no help if we don't admit that we have a problem. And all of us have sinned and come short of
Yes. Yes, Lord.
But the one thing about it, the Bible says we have an advocate with him.
Yes.
We can renew it boldly every day.
Every
day. Yeah.
Guess what? I don't have to come to a priest.
All right.
Yes, sir.
I don't have to be in the house of God to come before him. I can be in my own house and say, Lord, here I am. I've done wrong before you.
Yes.
Forgive me.
Yes.
Anybody know you're forgiven?
Yes.
He throws it into the sea of forgiveness.
Yes.
And don't remember it no more.
Yes.
Everybody else will bring your past up.
That's right.
Everybody else looks at you for what you used to be. Oh, but the blood. Andre Croft said, it reaches
the highest mountain.
To the highest mountain. It flows to the lowest valley. The blood. That gives me my strength from day to day. Because reality is sometimes this flesh gets weak. And we don't want to talk about it, but when you look over when Jesus was getting ready to go to the cross, his flesh got weak. And he said, Father, if it be thy will, let this cup pass. Then he called himself and said, not my will, but let thy will be done. And God saw where his son was getting weak and dispatched an angel down from heaven to go and strengthen him, because if he didn't go to Calvary, I wouldn't be able to be standing here today. If he had not died, I wouldn't be able to wave my hand like I'm waving my hand. If he had not died, but I'm glad he died. And not only did he die, but he got up with all power. Not some power, but all power in his hand. Everybody stand.
Glory!